Hey, I'm here. No worries. Okay. Thank you guys for being patient. I just needed 2 minutes to make sure things were good. Let me know in the comments right now. Can you see me? Can you hear me? Are we good? Okay. I think we're good. Cool. Thank you so much for being here. If you're new, I'm Camille. I'm a vocal coach with 30 Day Singer. And today we are breaking down Taylor Swift's style. This is exactly what I do with a student who's singing a song. We will listen to a song by that singer, and then we'll stop and start listening to these little really subtle sometimes stylistic elements. So I really encourage you to sing along with me when I stop and start. All right. Good. Let's jump in. First clip comes from Welcome to New York.
Walking through the crowd, the village is aglow. Kaleidoscope of loud heartbeats under coats. Everybody here wanted something more. Searching for a sound they hadn't heard before. And it's
I'm stopping right here. So listen, I'm going to go back a little bit and notice on the word for and da 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 da, whatever those two words were that rhyme with or. Notice how she ends with a little bit of air. So she sings the word for and then lets a little extra air escape. For, maybe not that obvious, but listen for it this time, and if you know the song, you can sing along too.
Of course, everybody here wanted something more, searching for a sound they hadn't heard before. And it's
you hear it that time? If you didn't hear it the first time, hopefully you did that time. Cool, let's keep going.
Say, welcome to New York. It's been waiting for you. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York.
Another thing to point out, welcome to New York. She's not just singing, welcome to New York, or welcome to New York. She's sliding or falling off of that pitch. Welcome to New York. And that really, that's very, very important about this song. We can't just sing, welcome to New York. We'll sound like robots. So try that. Welcome to New York. And let your voice fall at the end. If we slowed it down, it would sound something like, York, welcome to New York. Cool? It's a really cool effect.
Welcome to New York. It's been waiting for you. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York.
Every time she says the word York, she's letting it fall at the very end.
It's a new soundtrack. I can dance to this beat.
Okay, so she's also singing a little bit heavier than she normally does. What it sounds like to me is she's pushing just a little bit so that she can be heard in a big concert setting like this. I think that's pretty common. So she's singing not just beat, she's bending up to beat. I'm gonna go back a little bit so you can hear that.
Are so bright, they never blind me.
I went too far, or not far enough, actually. Here we go. So we're listening to this little scoop that happens on the word beat. Beat, instead of just beat. All right, this is subtle. This is what I'm talking about. Little tiny things make a big difference.
And it said, welcome to New York. It's been waiting for you. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York. It's been waiting for you. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York.
You know?
It's a new soundtrack. I can dance to this beat.
Beat. It's gonna happen again.
Beat forevermore. The lights are so bright.
Okay, so we have beat, a little bend up to that high note. And then when she sings me, She lets it be really, really light and head voicey. So it gives contrast. It gives dynamic contrast. More connected on beat and then light and floaty head voice on the word me. Let's keep listening. Welcome to New York.
Bags on apartment floors, took our broken hearts, put them in a drawer.
I hope now that we're at verse 2 and the melody is repeated, you're hearing those same things I pointed out earlier, like finishing with a little air.
Apartment drawers.
And she lets the air keep going even once her sound has stopped.
Everybody here was someone else before, and you can't want who you want. Boys and boys and girls, welcome to New York. It's been waiting for you, welcome to New York, welcome to New York.
So not a lot about this song is too difficult. I think so far the most important thing is getting that slide on welcome to New York. It just won't be the same unless you get that slide.
Welcome to New York. It's been waiting for you. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York. It's a new soundtrack. I can dance to this beat.
Oop! She didn't do it that time. She just went beat. She didn't do the little scoop.
Beat forevermore. The lights are so bright.
Again, she kind of lightened on that second, me, and you can hear the dynamic. She's going, it's a new soundtrack, I can dance to this beat, forevermore, and then she pulls it back when she's talking about herself. The lights are so bright, but they never blind me. So listen for details like this. If you are singing at one dynamic level, meaning one volume for the entire song, it gets boring pretty quick, and our ability to communicate and emote or sing with emotion is really limited if your dynamic is always the same. So as we keep listening, notice she's not always loud or always soft. She's playing between the two. Okay, I'm gonna jump to the next song. I think we got the gist of this one. Okay, so quick recap, that little fall. Being a little bit more connected on the word beat and then lightening up on the word me. Anything else that you heard, feel free to drop it in the comments. Okay. I think this is blank space that we're about to hear.
Nice to meet you where you been. I could show you incredible things. Magic, madness, heaven, sin. Saw you there and I thought, oh my God, look at that face. You look like my next mistake. Love's a game, wanna play.
Okay, a couple things. Saw you there, or saw you there. I can't remember what the melody was, but on the word there, she said there and stopped the sound. She didn't go there and finish the word, and she didn't linger on it for very long. Let's go back a little bit. I saw you there it is. I saw you there and I thought, oh my God. And then she did something cool just now before I pause. Let's listen to that again.
Nice to meet you where you been. I could show you incredible things. Magic, madness, heaven, sin. Saw you there and I
hear that, saw you there. And then stop the sound.
I thought, oh my God, look at that face. You look like my next mistake.
She's also using her speaking voice a little bit more. Oh my God, look at that face. She's not singing the whole thing. She's kind of using a little bit of speaking voice as well. Okay, we're gonna hear that cool thing right now.
Love's a game, wanna play.
Try this with me. Play. So we're stopping our sound in the middle of that word. Play. Good?
Hey, new money, suit and tie. I can read you like a magazine. fly. And I know you heard about.
And I know you heard about. She's not going, and I know you heard about. And I know you heard about. So what this is doing is it's a little bit more rhythmic, a little bit more punchy. She's getting her point across just more strongly. It's not all fluid and pretty. And I know you heard about. And I know you heard about. It's cool.
So hey, let's be friends. I'm dying to see how this one ends. Grab your passport and my hand. I can make the bad guys good for a weekend.
Not a lot of vibrato in this whole section. Da 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 da. She's not going da da da. She's restricting that vibrato again to give it a more speaking, punchy kind of sound.
So it's gonna be forever, or it's gonna go down in flames. You can tell me when it's over, if the high was worth the pain. I've got a long list of ex-lovers, they'll tell you I'm insane.
They'll tell you I'm insane, not... They'll tell you I'm insane. She's punching the word I. They'll tell you I'm insane. Again, this is a very forceful song, so she's using these vocal effects to make her point.
'Cause you know I love the players, and you love the game. 'Cause we're young and we're reckless.
Oh, I like that. You love the game, 'cause we're young. She gives it a little bit more depth than I think I hear on the album version. It's just like, you love the game. And it's kind of just shouted and you get off of it. But I like what she did here. She went, you love the game because you young. Sorry, I don't have the lyrics in front of me, obviously. But that was nice. Let's go back a little bit so you can hear it again and sing along with her if you fancy.
Or it's gonna go down in flames. You can tell me when it's over, if the high was worth the pain. I've got a long list of ex-lovers, they'll tell you I'm insane. 'Cause you know I love the players, and you love the game. 'Cause we're young and we're reckless, we'll take this way too far. It'll leave you breathless, or with a nasty scar.
Or with a nasty scar. She makes that word nasty sound a little bit nasty. She doesn't go, or with a nasty scar, and keep it all pretty. She, again, uses a little speaking voice, nasty. Or with a nasty scar. You can try that.
Got a long list of ex-lovers. They'll tell you I'm insane. But I've got a blank space, baby. And I'll write your name.
Cute, cute, cute. Okay, Mark pointed out she uses a glottal stop or a glottal onset on the word I'm, and that's exactly right. So Mark is pointing out that we have different types of onset. Onset is just how we start a note. So we could have a balanced onset. We could have a breathy onset. Or we can have this, a glottal onset. Which is a little bit harsh. Okay. Keep going.
Cherry lips, crystal skies. I could show you incredible things. Stolen kisses, pretty lies. You're the king, baby, I'm your queen. Find out what you want. Be that girl for a month. Wait, the worst is yet to come. Oh no.
Same thing on come. That is what we call a glottal stop. So she's stopping the sound with her throat, come, before continuing the word. And I see some of you in the live chat are asking about belting. So belting is a style of singing. Typically, we think about it as carrying a lot of chest voice or that speaking voice sound up quite high. I would say that Taylor doesn't do a ton of belting. She naturally kind of has this bright, a little bit nasal forward sound. And I think she uses that more often than not to get those high notes. I don't see a lot of belting, or what I think of as belting. Belting is subjective, by the way. There's not just one thing that is belting. So I will point belting out if I think I see it. But so far, I don't think we've had much beltiness.
Screaming, crying, perfect storms. I can make all the tables turn. Rose garden filled with thorns. Keep you second guessing like...
Another very important element in this song is the rhythm. Rose garden filled with thorns. If you're late on that, if you're just kind of sloppy, rose garden filled with thorns, it's not going to be the same. So we want space in between those lyrics. Rose garden filled with thorns. And you see she's kind of taking breaths in between. She's going rose garden filled with thorns. And I would say you don't have to do that. You don't have to take a breath. You can just take one good breath and then put a little space in between each lyric. Rose garden filled with thorns. And I think you can get close to the same effect, but with her breathing each time, rose garden filled with thorns, it gives this effect of like, we're a little bit desperate, we're out of breath, and if you want that effect, then that's a good way to get it.
Oh my God, who is she? I get drunk on jealousy, but you'll come back each time you leave, cause darling, I'm a nightmare dressed like a daydream. So
you can't sing this song without acting it. So you can see her, she's not just singing the notes, she is telling the story. I can't stress enough how important this is. So for whatever song you're singing, maybe you're working on this song, maybe you're working on something else, understanding the story and the character you're playing, because if you didn't write the song, then you might be kind of playing a character. So important to having a good, compelling performance. And I'll say Taylor Swift is great at this. Obviously, she wrote the song, so she can kind of bring true emotion to the song. But it's your job as a singer to do the very same thing, even if you didn't write the song.
It's gonna be forever, or it's gonna go down in flames. You can tell me when it's over, if the high was worth the pain.
Flames and pain. Those are what we call diphthongs, meaning double vowel sounds. Flames. We have A and E. And then pain. And you can hear she's emphasizing. She's not going flames or pain. She's saying flames and pain. And she's doing that on purpose because it's a cool sound. We get those distinct vowel sounds right after one another.
A long list of ex-lovers, they'll tell you I'm insane, cause you know I love the players and you love the game, cause we're young and reckless.
So you love the game cause we're young. I think we're getting closer to belty there because it sounds full, it sounds it sounds punchy. But it's not super, super high. And usually we think of belting as being a little bit higher than that. Anyways, I'm circling back to the belting question.
We'll take this way too far. It'll leave you breathless, or with a nasty scar.
It'll leave you breathless, less instead of breathless. It'll leave you breathless. Close your mouth, say less instead of less.
Got a long list of ex-lovers, they'll tell you I'm insane, but I've got a blank space, baby, and I'll write your name.
So you can see she's playing with this idea of like, they'll tell you I'm insane, just kind of acting, not insane, but you know, she's kind of playing the part.
Boys only want love if it's torture. Don't say I didn't, say I didn't warn ya. Boys only want love if it's torture. Don't say I didn't warn ya. So it's gonna be forever, or it's gonna go down in pain.
Say I didn't warn ya. Maybe getting slightly into belt territory, but again, I don't think it's that high for us to categorize it as a belt. Again, not a lot of vibrato. Like, this whole song, we have not heard that much vibrato. And then someone is asking about mixed voice. Manuel was asking about mixed voice. Manuel, almost every pop singer is utilizing some kind of mix. And if you're new, then mix is when we have any kind of balance between our chest function or speaking voice and then our head function, our woo, that voice. So yes, I would say that she definitely mixes. This is a nice still to be on right now. I would say she's definitely mixing when she uses that nasal sound that we hear sometimes on her higher notes. Okay, back to it.
You can tell me when it's over, if the high was worth the pain. Got a long list of ex-lovers, they'll tell you I'm insane.
She's being so playful. They'll tell you I'm insane. She's acting a little bit insane, kind of mocking them.
'Cause you know I love the players, and you love the game. 'Cause we're young and reckless.
Remember? Reckless. We're getting a little bit of that country accent. And in country accents, we often have these wide vowels. Instead of saying reckless, we're saying reckless.
We'll take this way too far. It'll leave you breathless.
Do you hear it? Breathless, not breathless. If we sang it, it'll leave you breathless. It's just too boring. It'll leave you breathless. A little bit, you know, edgy. Someone asked what punchy means. So by punchy, I mean we're singing with a... That's a really good question. I use that word, and I'm glad you asked. Punchy meaning we're singing like, hey, 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 instead of hey, hey, hey. So it's about dynamic, it's about intensity. You know, if you think of punching and you're singing, kind of having that same quality of like a burst of energy instead of just this smooth legato thing. Does that make sense? And then someone asked, what's vibrato? Vibrato is the naturally occurring vibration or oscillation of pitch in most voices. So if I sing with no vibrato, it sounds like this. If I sing with vibrato, ooh, it has that waver to it. Okay. By the way, last 15 minutes will be nothing but questions. So if I don't get to your question during the live stream, then last 10, 15 minutes will be just for you.
Or with a nasty scar, got a long list of ex-lovers. They'll tell you I'm insane, but I got a blank space, babe. And I'll write your name.
Oh, we heard just the tiniest bit of vibrato on the end. And I'll write your name. Just at the end. But that, yeah, that is a low vibrato song for sure. Okay, this is one of the more current videos that I found. This is Taylor at an award show singing Betty.
Betty, I won't make assumptions about why you switched to homeroom, but I think it's 'cause of me.
This song, we're gonna hear even more of that country accent. So if you want to sing country music, folk music, bluegrass, styles like this, your mouth position is going to be wider and flatter in general. So let's see once the camera closes up on her if we can see that.
Betty, one time I was riding on the skateboard when I passed your house. It's like I couldn't breathe. You heard the rumors from Inez. You can't believe a word she says most times. This time.
Most times. Not most times. Most times. It's a little country.
It was true. The worst thing that I ever did.
The worst thing that I ever did. get that slide. Don't just sing I ever did, because that's boring. The worst thing that I ever did. It's harder than it looks. You see Taylor Swift doing this and you're like, oh yeah, I can do that. But try it. You might need a little bit of practice, and that's okay.
Was what I did to you. But if I just showed up at your party, would you have me? Would you want me? Would you tell me to go straight to hell? Or lead me to the garden? In the garden, would you trust me if I told you it was just a summer thing? I'm only 17, I don't know anything, but I know I miss you.
But I know I miss. Miss, not miss. But I know that sounded like the same thing. But I know I miss you. Instead of, but I know I miss you. When I sing it like boring and proper, then you can hear this subtle little country accent coming through.
Betty, I know where it all went wrong. Your favorite song was playing from the far side of the gym. I was nowhere to be found. I hate the crowds, you know that. Plus, I saw you dance with him.
Listen. Plus, I saw you dance with him. She's not singing, plus, I saw you dance with him. Slide off of. Plus, I saw you dance with. This whole slide thing, it shows up in almost every style of music except for like classical and not a lot of musical theater. But contemporary, you know, pop, country, R&B, slides all over the place. And it's something that beginning singers, I think, their ears just aren't trained to pick up on. That's why I'm pointing this out. So now that you hear it, you can recreate it and you can get closer to T-Swift's sound. It really is all about the details. Okay, I'm gonna dial it back just a little bit so you can hear that again. And sing along if you want.
I was nowhere to be found. I hate the crowds, you know that. Plus, I saw you dance with him.
Plus, I saw you dance with him. It goes by quick, so you might need to slow it down like I did before. Plus, I saw you. And just get that coordination first, then speed it up.
You heard the rumors from Inez. You can't believe a word she says most times. But this time it was true.
Most times. That's so country. Brings me back. I listened to a lot of country music when I was little, so it's nostalgic.
The worst thing that I ever did was what I did to you.
Worst thing that I ever did ever is what I did to you. Just hear how much better it sounds when we sing did to you versus did to you. That connection between the notes, it's just, that's one of the things that sets apart more advanced singers from beginners. And I'm telling you, it doesn't take years and years of training to pick up on stuff like this. It's not technically that difficult. But you have to hear it first. You have to hear it.
But if I just showed up at your party, would you have me? Would you want me? Would you tell me to go straight to hell? Or lead me to the garden? In the garden, would you trust me if I told you it was just a summer thing? I'm only 17, I don't know anything, but I know I miss you.
Don't know anything, instead of don't know anything, don't know anything, but you know I miss you, instead of miss you. sorry to pause there, but I'm just pointing out, because I don't think I've said this yet. Taylor Swift, a lot of her songs are in a very manageable range for beginners. So this song in particular, if you're a beginning singer, I can almost guarantee you can sing this song with very little trouble. It doesn't go too low, doesn't go too high. So a lot of her stuff, especially her newer stuff, is very manageable. Limited range, not too challenging. And I highly encourage you to pick songs when you're a beginner that have a limited range so you can focus on more than just hitting the notes. You can focus on the stylistic stuff like this, rather than picking Love on Top on day one and just struggling to get those notes, squeak them out. Anyways.
I was walking home on broken cobblestones, just thinking of you, and she pulled up like a figment of my worst intentions. She said, James, get in, let's drive. Those days turned into nights, slept next to her, but...
Again, nights, slept next to her. This kind of calls back to Blank Space, where we were going, new money, suit and tie, and we had those pauses between the lyrics. Nights spent next to her. Don't miss that, because it's a cool effect. It gives an interesting rhythm, and it's not hard to do. You can do it. Easy.
I dreamt of you all summer long.
I think this is the end of this song, so I am scooching forward. You know, she sings a little more, but I think we got the gist. Okay, she kind of sang a lot more. Okay, this is a live performance of Lover.
Could leave the Christmas lights up till January. This is our place, we make the rules.
Did you hear that slide on "We make the rules"? She's sliding down off of the word rules. Let's hear if it happens again.
And there's a dazzling haze, a mysterious way about you, dear. Haven't known you 20 seconds or 20 years. Can I go where you go?
Pretty. Can I go? So we're starting in chest voice or your speaking voice. Can I go where you? And then go. And if you don't want to strain on you, I would modify to you. You instead of you.
Can we always be this close forever and ever? Take me home.
So in the previous songs, we didn't really hear a lot of her head voice. I mean, a little bit on Welcome to New York, but it's nice to hear her going back and forth between that chest voicey sound and head voice. And this is another reason why it's a little bit easier for beginning singers, because most of us have access to our chest voice, your speaking voice, and our head voice. Woo! You're in head voice. What's more difficult is developing that blend or mix of your registers, and that's where our vocal training really comes in. in addition to other things. But anyways, point being, if you're a beginning singer and you hear this kind of flipping in between chest voice and head voice, yeah, it might take a little bit to get used to, but it's easier than, let's say, mixing or belting.
You're my lover.
Got a little bit of that flat my instead of my kind of country accent.
We could let our friends crash in the living room.
in the living room. We don't hear her riff like ever. So that was cool. Okay, try that. Instead of singing in the living room, you're going to sing, I'll do it slowly, room. Try it slow, room. Speed it up, room, room. We could let our friends crash in the living room. Cool. That wasn't very clean, but keep practicing.
This is our place. We make the call.
Slide.
And I'm highly suspicious that everyone who sees you wants you. I've loved you three summers now, honey.
I've loved you three summers now. You're hearing that wide I instead of I. I've loved you three summers now.
But I want them all. Can I go where you go?
Pretty head voice.
Can we always be this close? Forever and ever on. Take me out, take me home.
We also hear I. She's on one note going from chest voice into head voice. Hi. Letting her voice crack. That's cool. That'll take a little bit of practice. I can drop a lesson for you in the chat if you want to learn that. Slides. I'm going to stop to answer a question or two. Allison is asking, do you need to control the volume between head voice and chest voice? That's a wonderful question. I think we can hear in a song like this that she's using that lighter head voice for stylistic effect. So it wouldn't really have that cool pop flip sound if she went, can I go where you go? She wants it to be light. Can I go where you go? And it sounds cool. In a different situation, yeah, we would want a little bit more dynamic, what's the word? Consistency, I guess. Really, that's where our mix comes in. And there's a question related to mix. Okay, Lauren's asking, sometimes I don't know if I'm head voice or mixed voice. How do I know for sure? That's a wonderful question. You might with mix, what it comes down to for a lot of singers is sensation. So we often will use like the hand on the chest to feel if we're in chest voice. If you're in a chesty mix, so if instead of singing, hey, you're going, no, and you're lightening a little bit, you're gonna still feel some chest vibration. If you're in head voice and you're singing, ooh, it, for me, it feels very light. Ooh, I'm not really feeling sensation anywhere, to be honest. But if I'm in mix, yeah, I'm starting to feel a little bit of sensation kind of in the front of my face. So I know that's not a great answer, but that is what it comes down to. For a lot of singers is sensation. And last question, Glitter is asking, what is a good and reasonably priced app to record a song? That's a good question and I don't have the answer to it. I'm not sure. If anyone else can weigh in on that, please do. Okay, back to it.
Magnetic force of a man to be mine.
For the sake of time, I'm gonna skip forward. I think we got the gist of this one. This one I might come back to. This is Cardigan. It's very nice, but no. We'll do Cardigan. Okay. Okay, here it goes. This is off her latest album.
New phone, high heels.
miles on cobblestones. When you are young, they assume you know nothing.
This is quite low. When you are... How low is that? Let's figure it out. When you are... Too low for me to sing late in the day. That's how low. Let's see. That's an E-flat 3. So, when I was saying before, Taylor Swift is great for beginners. The only caveat is sometimes she might go a little too low. Usually it's the opposite problem. Singers are going too high for beginners. Anyways, you can always, though, if you want, transpose a karaoke track up, or just on YouTube search Cardigan Karaoke Higher and see if anything pops up for you. Okay, keep going.
Sequin smile, black lipstick, sensual politics. When you are young, they assume you know nothing. But I knew you, dancing in your Levi's, drunk under a streetlight. I knew you.
Hear her vowels? I instead of I. I knew you.
Hand under my sweatshirt, baby, kiss it better.
Ooh, and we can see this kind of wider mouth position in this video. I love what she's doing dynamically here. And pulling back. That's hard to do.
And when I felt like I was an old cardigan under someone's bed, you put me on and said I was your favorite. A friend to all is a friend to none. Chase two girls, lose the one. When you are young, they assume you know nothing.
Okay, I'm skipping forward just for the sake of time. I think that's a pretty... technically not super challenging song. Beginners, take a look at it, but do look for a slightly higher karaoke track because that's quite low to be singing. Okay, we are ending with my favorite Taylor Swift live performance. This is her singing Wildest Dreams at the Grammy Museum, I think. And it's so different from the album version, which is one reason I really like it. But I just feel like she has so much power in her sound. And both of those performances, so the one I'm about to play and then Blank Space, same performance, same day. She just sounds so solid, so grounded. And I feel like in a lot of performances where she's dancing around, it's more common for her to be kind of out of breath. And it's nice to hear her just stand and sing. It's great. And I think it shows what she can do.
He said, let's get out of this town, drive out of the city, away from the crowds. I thought heaven can't help me now, nothing lasts forever.
Are you hearing, let's get out of this town, and now?
But this is gonna take me down, you soon.
Oh, that was so cool. This is gonna take... She just gets into head voice for a second and then back to chest voice for me down.
Oh, handsome as hell.
Oh, this is such good practice for beginners. He's so tall, handsome as hell. So this chest voice, head voice. He's so bad. So fun.
So bad, but he took it so bad.
Never mind, she stays big on bad.
And I can see the end as it begins.
She's switching it up on us. I like it.
My one condition is...
And some people in the comments are mentioning that breathiness is really breathy on the end there. I think we're about to hear this kind of brighter nasal quality I've been talking about when she goes high here.
Say you'll remember me. Standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset fade. Red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just
sings, "Say you'll see me again." That little stop in halfway through a word. Wildest dreams, wildest dreams, and I kind of like how rough that you can really hear the crack, the flip happening. It's cool.
I said no one has to know what we do. His hands are in my hair, his clothes are in the room, and his voice is a familiar sound. Nothing lasts forever, but this is getting good now.
So hear how bright and forward that is? It's loud for sure, but it's not super chesty. It's very nasal. So if you want to, this is going back to some comments before about developing mixed voice, taking your chest voice up higher. The key is not to just yell and go, hey, 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 and just hope that works. The key is to actually lighten and thin your sound enough to get over what we call your passaggio, or this kind of no man's land in between your chest voice and head voice, which a lot of beginning singers really struggle with. So a quick exercise that you can do to help bridge the gap between your chest and head voice and also lighten your chest voice as you ascend would be this bratty nasal kind of nay or no. So singing on a no, 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 no. Instead of singing on a hey, 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 that's not going to work. So we're using really bright no, 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 or nay, 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 and that can help you to find a smaller sound instead of that big shout or yell. And a lot of singers find success with using that little bit of nasality to kind of bridge their chest and head voice. Okay, jumping over to the chat, because we are now within 15 minutes of the end. Thank you guys for being here. Let me know what your questions are. They could be Taylor Swift related. They could be other. but now it's just about you guys who are here live, getting your questions answered. And I see people did weigh in and talk about GarageBand. So great. I didn't think of GarageBand because I thought, oh, do you need a mic for GarageBand? Anyways, glad you guys weighed in and have experience with that. Brianna or Brianna is asking, how do we get rid of tension in the neck and jaw? Also, I've been singing for a while and still can't really do vibrato. Any tips? Yes. So Brianna, we have a live lesson just like this one where I talked about vibrato and did exercises on vibrato for an entire hour. So I would check that first. Really, really quickly, some of the exercises at the very end are essentially using sounds that naturally kick you into that wavery place in your voice. So pretending like you're a ghost going ooh, and you can hear that kind of waver. Or what's another one that I really like? Pretending you're an opera singer. But I think that one actually is my favorite, doing that little ghost wail and seeing if that can kind of kick you into some kind of vibrato. Maybe not your most beautiful vibrato, but some kind. Okay, and then tension in the neck and jaw. My best tip for that is to move those muscles. So if your neck is starting to squeeze up when you're singing mum, 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 shake your head no, back and forth, mum, 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 and don't let it stop. Because your neck, if it's used to tensing, will want to stop. So mum, 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 mum. And then same thing for the jaw. Forcing it to move, going ya 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 ya, instead of ya 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 ya, and the jaw clenching up. Okay, let me look for this vibrato live lesson, and I will drop the link in the chat. Okay, here it is. Oh yeah. Good stuff. Okay, vibrato. There you go, my friends. Okay. Next question. Magnificent Precious is asking, when you get done eating, should you start singing after you finish eating? So I will find an article for you on food, drink, medication, how they affect your singing voice. So I'll get that for you and put the link. Okay, so food and drink. There you go. People are affected by different foods differently, so I'm not gonna say never eat sugar or never eat dairy. For me personally, I avoid sugar and dairy before singing because I've found that they affect me negatively. They can thicken the mucus on your vocal folds, but that article goes over that in detail, so check that out. Okay, Kristen is asking, I'm wondering about the position of the larynx. Is this important in chest/head voice? So Kristen, your larynx position, most singing teachers would say a neutral larynx, meaning not super low and also not super high, is ideal. Your larynx, let me tell you times when you would want your larynx to be in a slightly different position. If you want a kind of darker tone, then you might drop your larynx a little bit. If you want a lighter kind of poppy sound, you might raise your larynx. If you're belting, sometimes your larynx can come up a little bit. In general though, neutral larynx. And the big thing to point out is that your larynx height will impact your tone. So we want to use it for tonal adjustments, stylistic purposes, rather than your larynx being tied to pitch, because that is where a lot of us start out. The larynx wants to go low for low notes and high for high notes, and we have to retrain our larynx to remain relatively stable, regardless of pitch. Okay. Mark is asking, do you exercise your jaw before you started chewing your tongue, circling your tongue? So Mark's giving recommendations for releasing that jaw to who asked that? Brianna. Okay. Selena is asking, how do you act the song as you sing? That is such a good question. So what it comes down to, I think, is understanding what you're singing about first. If you're just singing these words as words, it's probably not going to mean very much. But if you understand what you're saying and you act as if these are your words, it's not just a song that Taylor Swift wrote. Pretend like you wrote those words, that you're in the position to say those words, and to get really specific about where you are, who you're talking to. All of that can really help put you into character. Brian is asking, my daughter is 7 and has been doing the beginner lessons for a week and a half. Is there anything in particular she should do or any limitations due to her age? Ooh, that's a great question. So Brian, young females in particular might have a breathier tone than, let's say, I do or another adult singer. So I would say very, very breathy tone. If she's singing, then we want to correct that. But don't be worried if her sound is lighter than you hear me or other adults, because that, it's, her vocal folds aren't fully developed and they actually can't come together totally yet. It's called a mutational chink, and you can look it up if you want. So other than that, my advice would be the same for any other beginning singer, that if it hurts, stop. Modify exercises as needed. So if something isn't going well, swap it out for another syllable that's easy for you to sing on, or another vowel. So let's say we're singing on an ah vowel and she's starting to strain or crack, switch to an oo vowel. If we're singing on an open vowel and just nothing's working, switch to singing on mum or bub or a lip trill. Yes. Okay. Manuel is asking, does exercising help to maintain, to keep your voice healthy? Manuel, I think so. I'm sure there have been studies on this, and I'm not educated on those studies, but exercising your body To me, I've noticed a big difference in my lung capacity when I'm in the habit of doing cardio, my heart's pumping, my lungs are expanding. I find that my breath support is much better. I am of the belief that healthy body will help support a healthy voice. There's one thing though, we've talked about this in the past. If you do like a lot of crunches, let's say, or a lot of weightlifting, you might have kind of overdeveloped your upper abdominals, and it might be a little bit harder for you to relax your belly when you're inhaling. So that's just something to look out for. But, you know. Okay. Glitter's asking, how can I sing the belting part of I Have Nothing by Whitney Houston? Glitter, let me send you a lesson on the foundations of belting. So getting your breath support, getting your mix going, these are things that we want to do before belting. So let me find that for you. Okay. Here you go. Belting fundamentals is what it is called. Okay. Mariani's asking, is it okay to chew gum before singing? I don't have any strong opinions on that. I chew gum kind of all the time. So if it's sugared gum and you notice a difference, so if you notice that, it's kind of harder to sing, then don't chew gum. Maybe you have to do an experiment for yourself. But I can't say yes or no. Omar's saying, I was doing daily warm-up routine every day. I noticed that my head voice is the one that's underdeveloped. I'm only doing head voice exercises now daily for 5 minutes with singing. Is this okay? Omar, it's not a bad thing to focus on your head voice, but I would encourage you to do some exercises that will start you in head voice and then bring you back to chest. So, for example, instead of just going, ooh, maybe you'll sing, because we do want to eventually build a bridge between your head voice and chest voice. Okay, and Brian is saying that the lip trill is a doozy. Brian, I'm with you. There are plenty of alternatives to the lip trill, so let me get an article for you that goes over that. Okay, here you go. You don't have to struggle forever with the lip trill. Magnificent is asking, is Brandy Norwood using head voice or falsetto in Broken Hearted? I don't know because I haven't heard that song. However, head voice and falsetto are the same function. The only difference is that head voice, we've got a little bit more connection, so it's a stronger sound. Versus for head voice, which is light, and there's a little bit more space in between our vocal folds. So I don't know if that answers your question. If it sounds airy and breathy, then we'd probably call that falsetto. If it sounds strong and connected, we might call that head voice. Lauren's asking, how long did it take to film the whole 30-day singer beginner course? That is a great question. I believe, if I'm remembering correctly, I think we filmed about 5 lessons per day. I could be wrong, but I think it was about 5. So that would have put it at 6 days, but they weren't subsequent. It was, getting the outline done, filling out what the exercises are going to be, and then writing scripts for those. And so it was a bit of an overlapping process, kind of finalize scripts for the first, 10 days, and then shoot the first 5, and then shoot 6 through 10, etc. Okay, and last question, Sandra's asking, is there a relationship between different vocal ranges and vocal registers? Yes. So, if you, Lauren's saying I wear the same thing. Yes, I did. That was purposeful. Sandra, yes. So if your vocal range How do I answer this question well? If you're a soprano, your break or passage between chest and head voice might be a little bit higher than an alto's. And then same thing for tenor and baritone or bass. I don't know if that's answering your question. If you have a wider range, then you'll probably have more head voice notes under your control, more chest voice notes under your control. I hope that answered your question. Okay. I'm going to let you guys go. Next week, we are breaking down Shawn Mendes. Excited for it. And I gotta answer that last person about different ranges. And then we're going. Okay, guys, thank you as always for being here. This is the link to find your vocal range. Here you go. And I hope to see you next week. I hope you found this helpful. I hope that as you listen to these songs, now your ear is picking up those small little details. And thank you for the suggestion. See you guys.